Hi everyone, I am Kiran Kumar. So today we are going to be discuss very important topic, that is nothing but amines. This is very important in a point of view of IIT, JEE, mains and NEET exams. So let's be going to the topic amines. First, nomenclature of amines. In this common name, IUPAC name is there. R in H2, if it is there, then we can call it as an alkyl amine. Common name is alkyl amine. Whereas IUPAC name is alkanamine. Alkanamine example. Now here CH3NH2, if it is there, then we can call it as a what? Common name is methylamine. Common name is what? Methylamine. Methylamine. Whereas IUPAC name is methanamine. What is that? Methanamine. Very important. IUPAC name is methanamine. Good. Next one, RNHR. We know that this is a secondary amine. So for the secondary amine, common name is dialkyl amine. Dialkyl amine. IUPAC name is N-alkyl amine. N-alkyl amine. Example, CH3NHCH3 if it is there. Then common name is what? Dimethyl amine. Dimethyl and amine. Whereas IUPAC name is N-methyl methanamine. N-methyl methanamine. Yes. Next, this is the tertiary amine. We know that. So common name is trialkyl amine. Whereas IUPAC name is N-N-dialkyl amine. N-N-dialkyl amine. See here example. CH3N-CH3-CH3 if it is there. Then we can call it as a what? N-N-dimethyl amine. This is the IUPAC name. N comma N dimethyl methanamine. This is the example of what? This compound. And this is the trimethyl amine, is the example for this compound. This is the common name, trimethyl amine, common name. Yes. Now next one here, ethyl amine. Ethyl amine. IUPAC name is ethanamine. Now this one, so we know that if the this group is attached, then we can call it as an iso group. Isopropyl amine. Isopropyl amine. Whereas IUPAC name is 2-amino. 1, 2, 3. So 2-amino, you know, propane. 2-amino propane. So next we are going to be switch over to our topic of basicity of amines. Basicity of amines. Hi viewers. So next topic is basicity of amines. So you know that ammonia NH3 is exist in the two derivatives. One is alkyl amine, another one is aryl amines. One is alkyl amine, another one is aryl amines. So in this alkyl amine, this alkyl group will give electron pairs to the nitrogen. When if it is give the electron pairs to the nitrogen, then nitrogen will get the electron density here more to donate to the external species. So if it is donate the electron to the other species, as per the Lewis acid base theory, so electron donating, otherwise lone pair donating, is called as a Lewis base. Whereas here aryl amines are there, no? Here the lone pair will be utilized by the ring. When lone pair is utilized by the ring, then this nitrogen is not having with the any extra electrons to donate to the external species. Due to this reason, the basicity order will be alkyl amines are more basic than the normal ammonia, and later on aryl amines are least basic. Aryl amines are least basic. Now, basic nature of aliphatic amines we are going to be compare. So as per the exam point of view here, I made this into the simple box. Here alkyl group means methyl, ethyl, after that propyl, butyl, whatever it may be. So methyl category or ethyl are more than that category, one thing. Okay, ethyl, even propyl, okay, and so on. So here in gaseous phase, we need to
remember that 3-2-1 as a code, mnemonic code. 3-2-1 after following of ammonia. So 3-2-1, tertiary, secondary, primary in gas phase, basicity of amines. When the methyl is attached, keep this thing in mind. When methyl is attached, then basicity order is 3-2-1 amine. Whereas in aqueous phase, 2-1-3 and followed by ammonia. Next, ethyl propyl, or furthermore if any alkyne is attached, then 3-2-1 ammonia and 2-3-1 ammonia. So why the reason means why the change will be here? Why not tertiary amine is having more greater basic strength than the secondary in case of this aqueous? Because here the factors are steric reason, steric hindrance is one of the factor, and along with that hydrogen bonding is one of the factor. So hydrogen bonding and steric hindrance, steric hindrance. So based on these two, we can remember this like as a 2-1-3 after followed by ammonia. Here the 2-3-1, just that much only. In case of cyclic amines, 3-2-1, like this only. Even in case of cyclic amines, means in any medium you can consider, like in a case of water medium, otherwise in case of gas medium, this is going to be maintained at 3-2-1 followed by ammonia. Yes, now you can see here, this is the tertiary cyclic amines, secondary cyclic amines and primary cyclic amines and followed by ammonia. So this is the order. Next one, here in aryl amines, tertiary aryl amines, secondary aryl amines and primary aryl amines are there. You know that. So how to arrange that? Increasing order of basic strength of their aryl amines. You know that. Here the ammonia, if it is there, means nitrogen on that lone pair is there. No, this lone pair wanted to take by these three rings. So furthermore, on the nitrogen atom, lone pair is not left out, right? So if the lone pair is not left out, then that does not going to be donate to the external spaces. Here, two aryl groups are there to take that. Okay. And here I need to write one aryl group. Okay. Now one aryl group is there to take that. So however, this is taking less compared with these three. That's why third member means primary aryl amine having more basic than the secondary aryl amine. Secondary aryl amine is having more basic than the... So primary aryl amine is having the more basic. This is the primary aryl amines. You can write this. Next one, this is the secondary aryl amine, which is this one. And first member is tertiary aryl amines. Okay, right. Next, here one more important question is pyrrole and pyridine. In between these two, which is more basic? So here the lone pair is there. No, this lone pair must be utilized in the ring. Then only we can count it as a 6 pi electrons. Because here the 2 pi electrons, here also 2 pi electrons. Including this lone pair, including that lone pair, it will become 6 pi electrons. As per the Huckel rule, if the 6 pi electron system is there, then we can call it as a stable, right? So 6 pi electron system is called as a stable, then this pyrrole will attempt the 6 pi electron system by including of this lone pair, by including of this lone pair. That's why here this is an aromatic character. If it is showing the aromatic character with the utilization of that lone pair, then on the nitrogen atom, now extra means to donate to the other species on the nitrogen atom, lone pair is not left out. But here, this pi electron, 6 pi electrons will be fulfilled without including this lone pair, without including that lone pair. If it is not including this lone pair, already the 6 pi electrons are there, now this is ready to donate. That's why here the pyridine is good base than the pyrrole. So in our next class, we are going to be see the preparation methods of amines. Preparation methods of amine. Okay, right. So today we are going to be discuss about the Gabriel thalamide synthesis. and it is a very very important reaction, Gabriel thalamide synthesis. Even this is useful in a preparation of amino acid also, and along with that in amines preparation of particularly primary amines we are going to be done based on this Gabriel thalamide process.
Okay, so here the first one, thalic acid. They may give the thalic acid, otherwise they give indirectly that xylene also, orthoxylene also. CH3. So when we do the oxidation on this xylene, so K2Cr2O7, heat out oxidation, alkmno4, then we can get thalic acid. Then we give like this also. So after that, when the ammonia is going to be reacted with this, you know, this lone pair is going to be attacked because of this pi bond is pulled by the oxygen atom, then here it will get the negative charge. Lateron, this negative charge wanted to give to this, and the OH wanted to disconnect. So here ammonia means amide is going to be formed. Here the amide is going to be formed. That amide, again the lone pair is there, no? That is going to be given for the, again C double bond OH. So with that, thalamide is going to be prepared. This thalamide having with the acidic hydrogen. Here we have a problem, how to detect the acidic hydrogen in the different types of the compound. So here I will tell them one technique, better trick. The trick is, suppose C double bond O, C, C, H, 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 H. So here how many acidic hydrogens are there? Acidic hydrogens, how many are there? So 6 acidic hydrogens are there. How to identify? Acidic hydrogen means in the sense that will be give the plus charge, or that should be released in the form of plus charge. So here you can consider, here part separation will be charge separation. Here the minus, plus, minus, plus, plus, plus. Here the plus means here the minus, plus, plus, plus. So 6 acidic hydrogens are there. Suppose when we go for the acetaldehyde, how many acidic hydrogens are there? Let's see. So this is what acetaldehyde, we know that. So this is the minus, here the plus, here the minus, here the minus, here the plus, plus, plus. So 3 acidic hydrogen, this is not acidic hydrogen, children. So keep this thing in your mind. This is not an acidic hydrogen. Just we need to separate the charges, then we can find out the acidic hydrogens very, very easily. Here also we can see how many acidic hydrogens are there in the thalamide. So here the minus, plus, minus, plus, right? So here the one acidic hydrogen is there. So if the acidic hydrogen is there, definitely whatever the NaOH is there, that is a good base, you know that, strong base event. This is going to be take the H plus from this. When the H plus lose in the form of H plus, then here the what? It will be leaves the minus charge on the nitrogen atom. So nitrogen and sodium will be attracted with this, and it will form the ionic bond. Later on, this will give the like electrons to a back donation or antibonding orbital of the carbon. So here it can donate the electron to the antibonding orbital of the carbon, means you got idea. This is SN2 process. Which mechanism? SN2 process. Based on the SN2 process, this nitrogen electron wanted to give for this, and alkyl means halide will be liberated. Right. And in the form of sodium halide will be liberated. So same reaction, if we go for the alpha halo esters, and after that followed by hydrolysis, same. So halogen will be liberated. When we do the ester hydrolysis, then we can get the amino acids. Means this Gabriel thalamide synthesis is very useful to prepare the primary amines and along with the amino acid also. So let me see that. Can we prepare this aniline by using of Gabriel thalamide process? Yes, I told you this mechanism. Now here, whatever the mechanism is following, this mechanism belongs to SN2 process.
Now, when we want to prepare this aryl amines, definitely we need to take halogen, right? So this halogen is not going to be liberated in a SN2. Why? Because when it is liberated in the form of SN2, then benzene will get the what? Cation. So on the benzene, if it, the cation is going to be formed, that is highly unstable because aromaticity is going to be loose. So due to this reason, we are not going to be prepare the aryl amines by the using of Gabriel thalamide process, because you know why? This X is not going to be liberated. Now, when we want to prepare this this particular amines, then what is the halide we need to take? We need to take the tertiary halide only, no? Isn't it? So this is the primary amine only, but we need to take the tertiary halide only, no? So when the tertiary halide, when we are going to be select, is this favorable for the SN2 reaction? So you know the tertiary halides are does not favorable for the SN2 reaction, because this lone pair means this minus charge 1 to 2 comes from the back side, less steric crowding side. So if the minus charge on the nitrogen atom, if it is 1 to 2 comes from the back side, this will be what they will do, this will react like it's a bodyguards. This won't allow the nitrogen minus charge to give the electron to the here the carbon. So this is also not favorable. Means we are not going to be prepared that particular amine. Okay. 2-methyl 2-amino 2-methyl propane, we are not going to be prepared by the using of Gabriel thalamide process. Now, can we prepare this amine? No. Why? Because this is the bridged head carbon. This bridged head carbon halogen is not going to be detached. Yes, sir. So this is also not going to be prepared, and this is the secondary amines also not going to be prepared based on the Gabriel thalamide process, because it will follow the SN2 mechanism. That's it. SN2 mechanism, and tertiary also not going to be followed. So which amines are going to be synthesized here? Purely primary amines. Which primary amines? So can we prepare the methyl amine means? Yes. Ethyl amine means? Yes. We can prepare this one. But even the comparison between these two, methyl amine we can prepare more than the ethyl amine, because of ethyl amine little bit steric crowding is there, no? Due to that reason, even the methyl amine tendency will be the more simple. The SN2 favorable reaction is there, no? That's where we can predict easily. After completion of Gabriel thalamide synthesis process, next important name reaction is Hoffman bromide degradation method. In this degradation method, same like as a Gabriel thalamide process, we are going to be prepare the primary amines. So let me see this reaction. First of all, here the amine we are selecting and reacting with the bromine in presence of NaOH strong base. So when we do this reaction, first of all, here primary amine sodium carbonate and sodium bromide is going to be formed. Now this amide is there, no? When it is reacts with sodium hydroxide, I told you already, here the minus plus minus and hydrogens will be the plus, so here the two acidic hydrogens are there, thus two acidic hydrogens are there, no? So one by one is going to be removed by the using of NaOH. Let me see that. Now first NaOH remove the one hydrogen and it will get minus charge, and sodium is attracted to this, and bromine is going to be cleaved by the donating of this minus charge to this, and bromine, one bromine will be eliminated. After that, here this N-bromo compound will form. This N-bromo compound is contains with the one more hydrogen. So minus, plus, minus, plus. So this hydrogen is more acidic than this hydrogen. This hydrogen is more acidic than this hydrogen. So however, in presence of the base, here this hydrogen is also going to be eliminated. So it will acquire the minus charge on this. Minus charge. So based on this, you can write the minus or lone pair. You can write the minus or lone pair. So here lone. So now this bromine, if it is going to be eliminated from this, then nitrene will form. Nitrene will form. So in a many books they given the nitrene formation. In some books without nitrene formation, here the isocyanate formations also they given. So they may ask anyone in the exam, so nitrene intermediate or isocyanate intermediate, they may ask anyone. So most of the books they prefer this only, standard books, isocyanate intermediate. So isocyanate intermediate, how that will form? This R will be, as it is, R will be attached to this, it simultaneously bromine will be detached from there. So based on that, here the isocyanate will form. When isocyanate is reacts with the NaOH, so simple mechanism, here the NaO, here the NaO, HH is going to be added to that, then RnH2Na2CO3 is going to be formed, you know that. So simple, nothing is there here, the acidic hydrogen we need to identify, that one by one is going to be eliminated, next rearrangement is going to be takes place. When this rearrangement is taking place, most important thing is whatever the configuration is there here, that configuration is maintaining as usual. Now here you can take. Here PHCH3H is there. So now we are going for the configuration. This is the 1 and this is the 2, 3, 4. So here 1, 2, 3, 4. So clockwise, even the fourth priority group in the vertical line as per the Pawn Ingold Prelog rules, SIP rules. So this clockwise rotation is called R configuration. This is the R configuration. Now this complete R configuration is there. No, this R configuration. Now this will be attached to this when the mechanism is going to be happening. So when it is attached to this, then R configuration will be retain their configuration. Configuration is not going to be changed here. Very, very important point. So configuration, if it is not going to be changed, then this is called retention configuration mechanism. Retention. Suppose if it is S, S only is going to be formed there. R, R is going to be formed there. And overall, how many NaOH molecules are used in this particular mechanism? So four NaOH molecules. Here the 1. And 2, here the 2 NaOH, so totally 4 NaOH molecules are useful to prepare this reaction. And here secondary and tertiary cannot be prepared. Secondary amine, tertiary amines are not going to be prepared. Why? When we want to go for the secondary amines, this R, 2 R's can be selected here, 2 R's can be selected, it is not possible. So primary amines only we are going to be prepared by the using of Hoffman bromide degradation method, but not secondary and tertiary amines. And this is the carbon degradation method, because here the whatever the carbon is there, that is going to be degraded, that is going to be reduced. So reaction intermediate is isocyanate or nitrate. Okay, now which of the following we can prepare by the using of HBD reaction? So definitely now this is going to be possible. Very, very important thing, this compound was not possible in the through the Gabriel Dalimide method, but here with this method just it wanted to shift to there. So cation is not forming, anion is not forming, just the rearrangement only there. That's why we can prepare the annealing by the using of Hoffman bromide degradation method, but this compound is not possible in Gabriel Dalimide method. Yes, ethylamine and this cyclopentylamine also we are going to be prepared, and this one, this secondary amine not going to be prepared, this secondary amine, this is also not going to be prepared. So this is about Hoffman bromide degradation method. Next very important reaction is Beckmann rearrangement. In this also we are going to be prepare the amines. So here oxime will be oxime. In this oxime, this OH group and alkyl, this alkyl and OH group means which are anti with each other, these are only involved in the reaction. Means this OH is going to be shifted to this carbon, and later on this alkyl will be shifted to there.
So based on this, here we can get the N-alkyl amide. When we do the hydrolysis of that, here the OH is going to be connected. Here the H means carboxylic acid and amines. So here we can get the another product is carboxylic acid. Right. Now with this, what we are getting? So OH will be transferred to this. OH will be transferred to this. pH will be transferred to this. So amine with contact with the phenyl groups. So we can call it as aniline also, no problem. So pH NH2 will form and CH3COOH will be formed. CH3COOH. What is the A here? What is the A here? This A is belongs to what? So N-alkyl, that is nothing but N-methyl amide will form. What is the structure of N-methyl amide? N double bond. Here the C. Here the CH3, here the OH, and here it will form pH. Okay, so pH will form there. An alkyl phenyl amine will form. Yes, here the CH3. This CH3 will be shuffled to this, and the OH will become this side. If they given the question like this, we can do very easily, no problem at all. But the thing is, when they given like this, means OH they given parallel to the base compound. So when the OH will be like that, then which has to be shifted? Means methyl has to be shifted and phenyl has to be shifted. So like this question they may ask, so here both products are going to be formed. Both products are going to be formed means here the methyl amine and PHCOOH benzoic acid as well as phenyl amine and acetic acid. So these four products are possible here also. So which one is anti, which is not anti, we cannot predict. Here also same like that, four products are possible. So this Beckmann rearrangement is monitored by the Lewis acid, very very important, and along with that protic acids also favorable for this reaction. So this is about the Beckmann rearrangement, and in the next class we are going to be discuss about the another preparation method like Schmidt reaction and Curtius rearrangement. Next important preparation of amine is Curtius reaction. In this Curtius reaction, acyl or acid chloride reacts with the sodium nitrite in presence of hydrolyzed means H2O and acidic protons, it will give the amines sodium chloride N2H2OCO2. So let me see this mechanism. You know that NaN3 is salt, so all salts are completely dissociate, you know. So here Na plus N3 minus will form this. N3 minus is act like as a nucleophile and it is attached to this. So nucleophile means which is going to be attached to the carbon, whereas base means which can abstract the proton from that. Okay, so in case of even amine bromide degradation method also, we have seen how the NaOH is attract the H plus from there. Okay, now here this is act like as a nucleophile. N3 minus is going to be attached here, the center nucleophilic center. Now here this compound will form, then this nitrogen lone pair will be given to this and it will give to this, and it is act, now it will become good leaving group because N3 means N triple bond N is act like as a good leaving group. So when it is want to leave, simultaneously this R want to shuffle their position, same retention. So here it want to occupy the this position, so same like that. So isocyanate is one of the intermediate. However, you know that in the previous reaction also we discussed that in that also isocyanate was intermediate. So when we do the hydrolysis of that, here the OH, OH, HH, then alkyl amines will form. So let me see the reactions here. The word acetyl chloride will react with the sodium nitrite and H2OH plus, then methyl amine is going to be formed. So here the N is going to be attached here. So this methyl is going to be attached here and hydrolyzed. So methyl amine is going to be formed. don't think that they will give always directly acid halide or acid chloride at the reactant side.
Even they will give the cyanobenzene also, means cyanides. With the cyanides also we can get the acid chlorides. How will it we see here? So cyanide group is going to be hydrolyzed, means with that hydrolyze it will become acid, carboxylic acid group, and thionine chloride is one of the reagent which can be give the Cl in there very easily. So SOCl2, then this Cl is attached here. This Cl after attaching, NaN3 is reacting with that, so this same mechanism is going to be followed. So in this, mostly
alkyl means amines are going to be synthesis. This is the one of the preparation for amines. Next, one more preparation method is Schmidt reaction. In this Schmidt reaction, whatever the carboxylic acid is there, that is reacts with the hydrochloric acid in presence of polar protic solvents, then it will give the alkyl amines. So amine preparation method, so as usually you know that the isocyanate structure, means isocyanate intermediate will form, then rearrangement is going to be happen. So you can come to know that here this nitrogen is going to be attached, then alkyl shift will be for this. So isocyanate intermediate, through the isocyanate intermediate only we are going to be get this amines. So till here we are going to be completed the preparation methods of amines. Next we are going to be discuss about the chemical properties of amines in the next class. Thank you. Here one more important point, this isocyanate intermediate formation. So in the Hoffman bromide degradation method and Curtius reaction, and in the Schmidt reaction also, isocyanate is one of the intermediate is going to be formed. So they will ask like this, which of the following reaction is happen or feasible through the isocyanate intermediate. So Hoffman and bromide, Curtius and Schmidt.